please like and comment on the video below. That will allow me to produce better quality videos and more of them in the future.
So when you first use BetAngel, you may not be optimizing all of the abilities of the product. You may not be using it to its full capacity, its full strength. And to do this, I'm going to show you on this video. So we're looking at a market here today. You can see prices are updating and things are happening. And on the top left here in the middle bar, you can see here that these are the prices at which these are the speeds at which you can refresh everything that's going on within the market. So you can go, you can refresh it just once a minute, or you can refresh it every 200 milliseconds. 200 milliseconds is 5 times a second. So you can see there's a bit of activity. There's not a huge amount of money in this market at the moment, so you can't see that much going on within here. But did you know that you can actually get BetAngel to refresh at 20 milliseconds, 10 times faster? Let me show you how you can do that. So if you click on the settings area in this middle bar, which is this little icon here, the spanner, and go to the communications tab, these are all of the settings relating to how you communicate with Betfair. So you can see you can modify all elements of the way that you communicate with Betfair and how frequently it asks for information from them. So this and 200 milliseconds is the mode that most API applications used, but Betfair introduced streaming a little while ago, and we were one of the first people to bring streaming pricing into BetAngel. To enable that, all that you need to do is tick this little box here, and then you have streaming enabled. And what happens now is, rather than having to ask for prices from Betfair every 200 milliseconds, prices get pushed to you. Now, if you want to make that the standard that you use, then you should do save as, and then save it as something like my default settings. And then what will happen is you can see that that will be switched on here, and then when you load up BetAngel next time around, it will default to those settings. You may want to play around with other features within that area as well. But you can see that we've switched the streaming on. You're thinking, well, what advantage is there to doing that, because it's still at 200 milliseconds? Incidentally, in the bottom right, you'll be able to see that streaming has been switched on. There's a little indicator down here that will indicate that streaming is switched on, and this will also has a tooltip on it to tell you that that is the case as well. So streaming is switched on. What is the immediate impact? Well, if we go up to here, you can see that rather than refreshing at 200 milliseconds, can you see below that there are loads of other options as well? So we can go down to 20 milliseconds now. So this will update incredibly fast. So somebody using a product that doesn't have streaming will only be able to call a maximum of every 200 milliseconds, but you can now do this every 20 milliseconds. So you will be calling and pulling off information from Betfair as fast as it arrives, and you'll be doing that 10 times faster than somebody that uses conventional polling. And there aren't that many apps out there that have switched to streaming, because it's quite a complex thing to implement. So if you want to use higher speed streaming, then obviously if you're using this for automation, you're triggering something into the market, or however you want to do it, then you're going to be getting this information very quickly, as opposed to the old method where you'd only be getting something every 200 milliseconds. As you can see, 20 milliseconds is much, much faster, 10 times faster than asking for the information every 200 milliseconds. But areas that you may want to consider using this, if we go to Guardian, if you're using automation or any of the Excel stuff, we can actually apply any one of these automation rules with inside Guardian. You can see at the moment it's only refreshing every 1 second. If I grab these markets, delete a load of them, you'll see the impact immediately. So if you look at how they're updating at the moment every 1 second, can you see it's going down and updating this every second? And then I'll go back to the top, or here rather, because those ones are suspended, and then it will count down from there. So there we go. There we go. But in Guardian, you can update this at 20 milliseconds as well. So can you see they're all updating simultaneously? So if you want to work with some automation in the background here while working in your main market, then that can be hugely beneficial if you're doing any level of automation, or you're doing something that allows you to get in or out of the market using automation while you're trading on the main screen. So yeah, you don't have to set it that high. You could set it to a much lower level. It all depends what you're wanting to do. But the default setting that you get is for polling, and that will poll at 200 milliseconds. And if you want it to update much, much faster, then you can actually update it 10 times faster by switching on the streaming, which you would do via the settings area and via the communications tab. You click over here, and then you can bring down the drop down menu here and change it from 200 milliseconds, and all of these much, much faster speeds will appear once you switch on the streaming.